लेक्चरर फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक भाईंदर। माय टॉपिक इज मेजरमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक पावर पार्ट 7, लर्निंग आउटकम्स। इन दिस वीडियो यू विल लर्न अबाउट टू वाटमीटर मेथड एंड वन वाटमीटर मेथड यूजिंग टू वे स्विच। सो फर्स्ट इज टू वाटमीटर मेथड। द टू वाटमीटर मेथड इज एक्सप्लेन टेकिंग एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ बैलेंस लोड। इन दिस वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट द पावर मेजर्ड बाय द टू वाटमीटर, that is the sum of the two wattmeter readings, is equal to root 3 times of the phase voltage and line voltage, that is root 3 VL IL cos phi, which is the actual power consumed in a 3-phase balance load. The connection diagram of a 3-phase balance load connected as star connection is shown below. So this is the diagram of two wattmeter methods. In this, W1 and W2 are the two wattmeters which are connected in R and Y phase respectively. The pressure coil of these two wattmeters are connected to B phase. In this, VRN, VBN and VYN are the phase voltages. IR, IY and IB are the currents, line currents. And the load in this diagram is star connected load. The load is considered as an inductive load, and thus the phasor diagram of the inductive load is drawn below. As you know, for inductive load, current lags the voltage. So in this diagram also you can see the IB is the current which lags the voltage by an angle phi. Next, IY also lags the voltage VYN by an angle phi. And IR also lags the voltage VRN by an angle phi. And IB, IY and IR are the line currents which are displaced by 120 degree from each other. VRN, VBN and VYN are the phase voltages which are also displaced 120 degree from each other. The three voltages VRN, VYN and VBN are displaced by an angle of 120 degrees electrical as shown in the phasor diagram. The phase current lag behind their respective phase voltages by an angle phi. Now the current flowing through the current coil of the wattmeter W1 will be given as W1 is equal to IR. The potential difference across the pressure coil or potential coil of the wattmeter W1 will be W1 is equal to VRB is equal to VRN minus VBN. As the current flowing through the wattmeter is IR and voltage across this wattmeter, that is potential coil, is connected across the R and B phase. So the voltage across the potential coil becomes VRB. So W1 is equal to VRB is equal to VRN minus VBN for W1. To obtain the value of VYB, reverse the phasor VBN and add to it to the phasor VYN as shown in the phasor diagram above. The phase difference between VRB and IR is 30 minus phi. Therefore, the power consumed by the wattmeter W1 is W1 is equal to VRB IR cos 30 minus phi. Current through the current coil of the wattmeter W2 is given as W2 is equal to IY. The potential difference across the wattmeter W2 is W2 is equal to VYB is equal to VRN minus VBN. So the wattmeter W2 is connected in Y phase. So current flowing through this wattmeter is IY and the potential coil of this wattmeter is connected between the phases Y and B. So the voltage across this potential coil becomes VYB. So VYB is given by VRN minus VBN. The phase difference VYB and IY is 30 plus phi. Therefore, the power measured by the wattmeter W2 is given by the equation shown below. So W2 is equal to VYB into IY cos 30 plus phi. Since the load is in a balanced condition, hence IR is equal to IY is equal to IB is equal to IL and VRY is equal to VYB is equal to VBR is equal to VL. Therefore, the wattmeter readings will be, you can write it as W1 is equal to VLIL cos 30 minus 5 and W2 is equal to VLIL cos 30 plus 5. Now, the sum of the two wattmeter readings will be given as W1 plus W2, which you can write it as VLIL cos 30 minus 5 plus VLIL cos 30 plus 5. Next, take VLIL common, then you can write it as VLIL in bracket cos 30 minus 5 plus cos 30 plus 5. And here you have to use the formula for cos A minus B and cos A plus B. So you can write it as VLIL cos 30 cos 5 plus sin 30 sin 5 plus cos 30 cos 5 minus sin 30 sin 5. Or next you can solve again and you can write it as VLIL in bracket 2 cos 30 cos 5. Further again you have to solve this. You can write it as VLIL in bracket 2 into root 3 by 2 cos 5. Next 2 cancel and you get the equation W1 plus W2 is equal to root 3 VLIL cos 5. And root 3 VLIL cos phi is the active power. So write it as P. So W1 plus W2 is equal to P. So by adding two wattmeter readings, you will get the power. The above equation 1 gives the total power absorbed by a 3-phase balanced load. Thus the sum of the readings of the two wattmeters is equal to the power absorbed in a 3-phase balanced load. Next one is determination of power factor from wattmeter readings. As we know, W1 plus W2 is equal to root 3 VLIL cos phi. Now, W1 minus W2 is equal to VLIL cos 30 minus 5 minus cos 30 plus 5. Or you can write it as VLIL in bracket cos 30 cos 5 plus sin 30 sin 5. Minus cos 30 cos 5 plus sin 30 sin 5. Further, you can solve it as W1 minus W2 is equal to 2 VLIL sin 30 sin 5. So again, you will get the equation W1 minus W2 is equal to VLIL sin 5. As sin 30 is 1 by 2, 2 cancel, you get the final equation W1 minus W2 is equal to VLIL sin 5. Next, dividing equation 3 by equation 2, we get W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2 is equal to VLIL sin phi upon root 3 VLIL cos phi. So sin phi upon cos phi is tan phi. So write it as tan phi. So tan phi is equal to root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. The power factor of the load is given as cos phi is equal to cos of tan inverse root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. So in this way you can find power factor also by using two wattmeter method. Next is effect of power factor on wattmeter readings in two wattmeter method. Now we will consider three cases and we'll observe how the individual wattmeter measures the power in each case. So here is the case first. When the power factor of load is unity, as the power factor of load is unity, hence phi equal to 0. Therefore, power measured by first wattmeter W1 is equal to VLIL cos 30 minus 0. So the VLIL cos 30 is equal to 0.866 VLI. So if the value of phi is 0, you will get first wattmeter reading as 0.866 VLI. Power measured by second wattmeter W2 is equal to VLI in cos 30 plus 0. So VLI cos 30 is equal to 0.866 VLI, thus we see that when the power factor of load is unity, then both the wattmeter reads the same value. So for power, unity power factor, you get W1 is equal to W2. Second case, when power factor of load is 0.5 lagging, as power factor is 0.5, hence cos phi is equal to 0.5, that is phi equal to 60. Therefore, power measured by first wattmeter W1 is equal to VLI cos 30 minus 60. So put phi is equal to 60. So we get first equation W1 is equal to VLI cos 30 minus 60. Again solved it further, we get VLI cos 30 is equal to 0.866 VLI. Next, power measured by second wattmeter W2 is equal to VLI cos 30 plus 60. So 30 plus 60 is 90. So we write it as VLI cos 90, and cos 90 is 0. So W2 becomes 0. Thus we see that when power factor of load is 0.5 lagging, then power is only measured by first wattmeter and the reading of second wattmeter is 0. Next, case 3, when power factor of load is 0, as power factor of load is 0, hence cos phi equal to 0, that is phi equal to 90 degree. Therefore, power measured by first wattmeter W1 is equal to VLI cos 30 minus 90 is equal to VLI cos 60. So cos 60 value is 0.5, so is equal to 0.5 VLI. Power measured by second wattmeter W2 is equal to VLI cos 30 plus 90 is equal to minus VLI cos 60 is equal to minus 0.5 VLI. So cos 30 plus 90, which becomes 120 degree. So write it as cos of 120 degree, or you can write it as minus cos 60. So we see that when power factor of load is 0, then one wattmeter read is positive while second wattmeter reads negative. As second wattmeter reads negative, hence wattmeter won't read anything practically. Therefore, for second wattmeter, we need to interchange the leads of either pressure coil or current coil so that second wattmeter may read value. As we have interchanged the connection of leads of either PC or CC, hence second wattmeter will read positive. But while calculating the total power measured, we must take the reading of second wattmeter as negative. So it shall be noted that when 60 is less than 5, less than 90, reading of one wattmeter will be positive, while the reading of second wattmeter will be negative. So practically it is not possible to taking reading as negative. So we have to interchange the connections of wattmeter while taking the second wattmeter reading. And by interchanging this connection, you can take the reading, but note down this reading as negative. Next, advantages of two wattmeter method. So both balanced and unbalanced load can be balanced using this method. So this method is effectively used for balanced load as well as for unbalanced load. In a star connected load, it is optional to connect neutral point of wattmeter. And in delta, connected load connections need not be open to connect wattmeter. Next, three phase power can be measured using two wattmeters. Both power and power factor is determined on a balanced load condition. So these are the advantages of two wattmeter method. Next are the disadvantages of two wattmeter method. Not suitable for three phase four wire system. Primary windings W1 and secondary winding W2 must be identified correctly to prevent incorrect results. So for taking reading, while taking reading, it depends upon the power factor. So if the power factor changes, the wattmeter readings also changes. So this is the main problem of this two wattmeter method. नेक्स्ट वन इज वन वाटमीटर मेथड यूजिंग टू वे स्विच. सो हियर इज द डायग्राम ऑफ वन वाटमीटर मेथड. इन दिस दे हैव यूज टू वे स्विच टू कनेक्ट द प्रेशर कॉयल टू द टर्मिनल्स. इफ वी कनेक्ट द स्विच टू फर्स्ट देन द प्रेशर कॉयल इट गेट्स कनेक्टेड बिटवीन आर एंड वाई टर्मिनल्स. एंड इफ वी कनेक्ट विद स्विच टू देन द प्रेशर कॉयल ऑफ दिस वाट मीटर कनेक्टेड टू आर एंड बी टर्मिनल्स. सो दिस मेथड इज टू बी यूज फॉर बैलेंस लोड्स ओनली एंड इट इज अ मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ टू वाट मीटर मेथड ऑफ मेजरिंग द पावर. द वाट मीटर करंट कॉयल इज कनेक्टेड इन वन लाइन एंड द रीडिंग्स ऑफ वाट मीटर आर टेकन बाय कनेक्टिंग इट्स प्रेशर कॉयल अल्टरनेटली across the line voltages with the help of a changeover switch and the values of W1 and W2 are obtained. Adding W1 and W2, the total power supplied to the circuit is determined. So by connecting switch to first terminal, we get 1 watt meter reading and by connecting the switch to the second terminal, we get another reading. So in this way, we get two readings W1 and W2, same as two wattmeter method. And by adding both readings, we get the total power. So this is the phasor diagram for this method. Since the load is balanced, phase voltages are equal. That is VR is equal to VY is equal to VB. So also line voltages VR is equal to VY, VYB is equal to VBR is equal to VL are equal. Also IR is equal to IY is equal to IB, line or phase current is equal to IL. So when switch is connected to 1, the pressure coil receives the voltage VRY and reads the power W1. When switch is connected to 2, second terminal, then pressure coil receives VRB and wattmeter reads the power W2. So therefore W1 becomes W1 is equal to VRY into IY cos of 30 plus 5 and W2 becomes VRB into IR cos 30 minus 5. So using generalized notations we can write W1 is equal to VLIL cos 30 plus 5 and W2 is equal to VLIL cos 30 minus 5. So further we can solve it as W1 plus W2 is equal to VLIL cos 30 plus 5 plus cos 30 minus 5. Again solve this bracket cos 30 plus 5 and cos 30 minus 5 by using formulas of cos A plus B and cos A minus B is equal to VLIL cos 30 into cos 5 minus sin 30 sin 5 plus cos 30 cos 5 plus sin 30 sin 5. So minus sin 30 sin 5 and plus sin 30 sin 5 get cancelled and add this to cos 30 cos 5 plus cos 30 cos 5 which becomes 2 cos 30 cos 5. So final equations become VLIL in bracket 2 cos 30 cos 5 and value of cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So put this value in this equation, we get further VLIL in bracket 2 into root 3 by 2 into cos 5. 2 get cancelled and final equation becomes root 3 VLIL cos 5. So W1 plus W2 is equal to root 3 VLIL cos 5. Hence total power is equal to W1 plus W2. Next W1 minus W2 is equal to VLIL cos 30 minus 5 minus VLIL cos 30 plus 5. So again this solve and we get the equation VLIL 2 sin 30 sin 5. Sin 30 value is 1 by 2. So put this value in equation, we get the equation VLIL into 2 into 1 by 2 sin 5. 2 get cancelled and we get the equation W1 minus W2 is equal to VLIL sin 5. Next, determination of reactive power. In case of three-phase circuit, the reactive power is equal to root 3 VLIL sin 5. So, if we multiply equation by root 3, we get total reactive power of three-phase circuit. रूट थ्री इन ब्रैकेट डब्ल्यू वन माइनस डब्ल्यू टू इज इक्वल टू रूट थ्री वी एल आई साइन फाइव. सो वी गेट डब्ल्यू वन माइनस डब्ल्यू टू इज इक्वल टू वी एल आई साइन फाइव एंड फॉर्मूला फॉर रिएक्टिव पावर इज रूट थ्री वी एल आई साइन फाइव. सो इफ वी कनेक्ट दिस इक्वेशन बाय रूट थ्री वी गेट द रिएक्टिव पावर. सो टू मेजर द रिएक्टिव पावर वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई डब्ल्यू वन माइनस डब्ल्यू टू टू रूट थ्री. सो रूट थ्री इज इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू रूट थ्री इन ब्रैकेट डब्ल्यू वन माइनस डब्ल्यू टू इज इक्वल टू रूट थ्री वी एल आई एल साइन फाइव. सो इट इज पॉसिबल टू कैलकुलेट द टोटल रिएक्टिव पावर. सो इन दिस वे यू कैन कैलकुलेट रिएक्टिव पावर. नेक्स्ट डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ पावर फैक्टर. पावर फैक्टर कैन बी फाउंड बाय फॉलोइंग मेथड फ्रॉम इक्वेशन वन डब्ल्यू वन प्लस डब्ल्यू टू इज इक्वल टू रूट थ्री वी एल आई एल कॉस फाइव एंड इक्वेशन टू इज डब्ल्यू वन माइनस डब्ल्यू टू इज इक्वल टू वी एल आई एल साइन फाइव. सो इक्वेशन वन डिवाइड इक्वेशन वन बाय टू वी गेट डब्ल्यू वन माइनस डब्ल्यू टू इज इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू वन माइनस डब्ल्यू टू अपॉन डब्ल्यू वन प्लस डब्ल्यू टू इज इक्वल टू वी एल आई एल साइन फाइव अपॉन रूट थ्री वी एल आई एल कॉस फाइव. सो साइन फाइव डिवाइड बाय कॉस फाइव इज टेन फाइव. सो राइट इट एज टेन फाइव. सो वी गेट द इक्वेशन रूट थ्री डब्ल्यू वन माइनस डब्ल्यू टू अपॉन डब्ल्यू वन प्लस डब्ल्यू टू इज इक्वल टू टेन फाइव. सो बाय टेन फाइव वी कैन कैलकुलेट फाइव. सो फाइव इज इक्वल टू टेन इनवर्स ऑफ रूट थ्री डब्ल्यू वन माइनस डब्ल्यू टू अपॉन डब्ल्यू वन प्लस डब्ल्यू टू. सो वी वॉन्ट पावर फैक्टर. सो मल्टीप्लाई बोथ साइड विथ कॉस कॉस देन वी गेट cos phi is equal to cos of tan inverse of root 3 w1 minus w2 upon w1 plus w2. So in this, by using this formula, we can also calculate power factor by using this method.